Hello everyone. Today's company we are going to analyze is Info Edge India Limited. Info Edge India Limited is a online service company. It's an online service company, and majorly it has its business portfolio composed of four online services, like in recruitment business Naukri.com, and in matrimony jeevanshathi.com, in real estate 99acres.com, and in education shiksha.com. And beside this, in another vertical, it also in a way work as a venture capitalist, where it invest in various startups and emerging and growing companies. Among its major investee companies, there are Zomato, Policy Bazaar, and Merit Nation, etc. Info Edge India was incorporated in 1995 as a private company, and it became a public limited company on 2006. And talking about its network, there are 62 offices located in 43 cities and has 4049 employees. Now talking about the industry where Info Edge India is operating. According to a report by Google, it says that the online classified industry is about to grow at a CAGR of 22.5%. And if we look at the online hiring industry, I'm going to talk about more regarding Naukri.com and 99acre.com, because the major revenue generator for Info Edge India Limited are these two websites. So the online hiring in India grew by 15% from in 2019 compared to 12% in 2018, and the real estate sector is expected to reach market size of $1 trillion. So there is a huge market to be tapped, and for any online classified industry to grow, the internet users is a major factor alongside the internet penetration. So if we look at the number of internet users in India, the annual growth rate is 18%, and there are 627 million internet users by December 2019, and the internet penetration is around 40%. Now talking about the quality of business and management, majority of the stake of the company is its promoters, and it has zero promoter place. Promoter place means the shares have not been placed to raise any working capital or any other loan. The company has efficient cash conversion cycle of 28.57, which reflects the efficiency of the business. And it has also maintained the effective average operating margin of 28.04% over the years, which shows the consistency of the management and the business over last 5 years. And Naukri.com is continued to be the market leader in recruitment business over last 5 to 4 years. And if we talk about the traffic share of its business, like Naukri.com, it's about 80 to 85%, and for Naukri.com it's 52%. It's an achievement because despite the our Indian real estate sector is not performing well for quite 2-3 years, but despite that, Info Edge has maintained its fair share in the market. And its billing also grew by 28.51% in the 2019. Now talking about the growth in earning, recently in 2019 the company has acquired 100% share capital of IIM Jobs, which was prior to this acquisition was into in the recruitment of applicants from various premier institutes. So acquiring this company, it will add to the business of the company in the upcoming years. And the company is not only looking at its current business, it is also planning well for its future expansion and future growth aspects. Like it has इंक्रीज इट्स 50% इंक्रीज इन द मार्केटिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी एनहांसमेंट स्पेंड्स फ्रॉम 1,163 मिलियन इन 2018 टू 1,756 मिलियन इन 2019। एंड टॉकिंग अबाउट द नौकरी डॉट कॉम, आई विल से दैट द मेजर थिंग दैट मेड नौकरी डॉट कॉम मार्केट लीडर इज द RMS टेक्नोलॉजी। RMS इज द रिक्रूटमेंट मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम। इट्स ए कम्प्लीटली ऑनलाइन प्रोसेस विथ फ्रॉम द स्टार्टिंग ऑफ द एप्लीकेशन टू प्रोसेसिंग ऑफ द एप्लीकेशन एंड द हायरिंग प्रोसेस। इट हैज़ मेड द कम्प्लीट प्रोसेस ऑनलाइन, सो इट हैज़ इंक्रीज द एफिशियंसी ऑफ द बिजनेस। नाउ longevity of quality and growth. The company has maintained a stable cash flow of 16,170 cash balance, and they have currently a cash reserve of 16,170 million. A cash reserve will help the company in stress scenarios like currently the coronavirus case, and they have very low outside liability in their balance sheet. And if you talk about the invest companies, like I said, they work as a venture capitalist. Out of their investment portfolio, there are 15 companies that they have invested now currently in growth phase. So in the upcoming year, they will also they are expected to also grow. And they have not blindly invested in various companies. They are very choosy in their picking up their investment. Like they have gone for investment which are similar to their business, like in which are operating in online classified industry or online IT services like that. So recently they have invested in Stock Connect and shopkirana.com etc. And regarding the price, the EPS of the company is currently trading on 23.12, and book value of the company has improved over the last 2 years. If you look at the P, it slightly look a higher number, which is 128.9, but the company is growing, and the cash flow it is generating at a rapid pace. Like if we look at the EPS of the company, it's growing and it's also expected to grow in the upcoming years. So with the increase in the earning over the year, the PE is also expected to come to a smaller number. Now Isa will continue.
Yeah, so continuing the story in graphs, first graph shows the EBITDA and the EPS. So EBITDA has been continuously increasing for the company, and for the EBITDA, the recruitment solutions have grown by the 17.51% in 2019, and the second major contributor is the real estate business. And for the next and EPS is not stable. For the second graph, revenue in millions, where the four major revenue comes from the Naukri.com, 99acres, Jeevansathi and Shiksha.com. So for the Naukri.com, the number of unique customers have increased with a CAGR of 15%, and the number of resumes have increased with CAGR of 11.3%. And the recruitment solution is the company's core business. So the two major sources of revenue is like first is from recruiters, and which accounts for almost 90% of its revenue. And second one is from the job seekers, which relate to all the job seeker advisory services, and which accounts for 10%. Talking about the next is 99acres, where the number of listings have been increased with CAGR of 7.3%, and the number of paid listings have been increased with CAGR of 4.8%. And so it has been increasing year on year. The next is Jeevansathi. So it has basically two strategic focus. One is that it covers specific communities to grow revenues, And on the other hand, emphasis is being laid on to convert the already existing community to increase their use of paid services. And the next is Shiksha.com. So Shiksha.com has grew by 13.01%, and the revenues are generated through lead generation for institutions, like in terms of potential students or the applicants' details about the college and their agents. Now, talking about the risk and concerns, like here there are many risks for the company, and the major risk is like the company has an exposure of investment worth 8,092 million in investee startup. So there is a probability that this entire investment might not generate much returns and absorb more cash flow in the incubation and the early phase. Like already 2,180 million, or the 26.94% of all such investments ever made have been written off. And so there is the probability that this entire investment might not generate return. So this is the risk. Secondly, the company relies heavily on the recruitment business, as it like it is almost 70% of the total revenue generated, and the company is heavily dependent on the profits and the cash flows. So it is a concentration risk for the company. Now, like for example, like third one is the being the knowledge-driven industry, business, significant increase in people attrition. Like if we talk about the Shiksha.com, the people will get people know about all those things, so there will be frequent attritions, and which is a threat to the business of the company. The next is like most of the portals rely on information being posted by users. So like fraudulent postings and the profiles which are there on the website, and spamming by some of the users may damage the reputation of the company. And like it may create the defamation and the invasion of the privacy. So even this is the major risk. And this risk of the fraudulent postings and the defamation, it has been termed as the content liability for the company. So from here, Manisha will continue.
Already, and Isha has already. Now my part is financial summary. We have taken few important for accumulating all the important points like net revenue, book value by share, profit after tax, return on. Already known that the recruitment another source of income for Edge. But if we see the CAGR of all the three major companies like recruitment, matrimonial, real estate, the major CAGR is seen in the real estate, which is around 21%. And if we for matrimonial, it's around 15%, and for recruitment, it's around 14.1%. Now, if we see the book price value by book value, it's like higher the value, higher if the value is higher, the market is ready to give the premium amount. I mean, the higher the ratio, the higher the premium market is willing to pay for the company. So basically, what happened is initially, when COVID happened on 23rd March, Info Edge had the lowest stock price, that was around 1600, and on 24th March, it came into news that Info Edge with other two companies are entering into are included in the NSE futures and options, from where it started to increase, and ROE, return on equity, and book value per share, that there is a gradual increase, and in 2021, it is expected to increase by from 212.43.8 and 20.32 to 22. So if we see, if we analyze the cash cash balance sheet and all. Total revenue is already included by the Indian group. Purposes, we had a major use of cash inflow, and because can you lower the and the employee cost is around 40% of the revenue. Now, if you go for the pure comparison, because can you downwards? Okay. Now, if we see the peer comparison, Info Edge is basically into the service sector. So, Info Edge with eClerx services, IndiaMART, First Source solution, we have tried to do the peer comparison. Info Edge has the major market cap, which is around 31.06 million, and which is much more than all the other companies. And if we see the sales growth, Info Edge is into the middle of, I mean, is increased by 34%, whereas IndiaMART has been has a very greater sales growth, whereas First Source solutions do not. And if ROE also, it has a very marginal one, and the operating margin. Now, if we come for the conclusion and the investment view, why do we think that we should invest in Info Edge? Is one thing is because we know Naukri.com is a major, and people are now losing job. However, maybe we will not have major companies coming up for recruitment purposes, but in 2021, it is expected that there would be increase in number of market will require people, skilled people, and already OH has the major revenue source from IT and IaaS sources. So India being a major generator of technical people, and Naukri, Info Edge has been increasing, has increased investment in AI product design, data science, which is a major deciding factor, because nowadays companies are involving in and coming up to date. And if we see the real estate business, that is already affected by COVID in a drastically manner. Hence, 99acres won't be able to give good returns as of now. But after we surpass 2021, it is that it will try to grow in a smaller way. I mean, the increment. And I've already said that Info Edge is already into the options that has already been listed. Info Edge won't be a good return as of now, and all and Info Edge to be rigid in this market may and stock price very very to 2000 something. Only lowest was on that was on 23rd March. After that, it has already has been increasing with a slight deviation plus and minus. So in the current market, won't be able to get a good return, but if we have patience, this investment would be a good opportunity. So this is how we conclude.